In my main video about proportional representation, I talked about a country called Non-Existan and its 8 political parties. I'm sure the pun in Non-Existan was fairly obvious, so right now I'd like to talk about Existan for a bit, the Existan in question being the United States. This is partly because a lot of RobertExplains subscribers are from that country, according to the analytics, and partly because the US is less exposed to neighbouring countries or internal movements advocating PR than other FPTP countries are, so the consequences of switching voting systems might not be as readily apparent there. The first thing I need to say is that the US has presidential elections, which are a rarity in Europe because European countries tend to have parliamentary systems in which the president or prime minister derives his mandate from parliament. This needs to be addressed because when only selecting a single person to a single position, FPTP and PR basically do the same thing and will lead to the same result. When it comes to electing a parliament, however, or a congress as it's known in the US, the differences are enormous. To Europeanize, it is odd that the movements within US parties, like the Democratic Socialists of America or the Tea Party, are not parties in their own right. This is entirely because of the spoiler effect, and I would personally argue that it is actively hurting the US as a country. Without this negative effect of FPTP voting, the entire Republican Party wouldn't feel the need to stand in solidarity with a president that isn't ideologically compatible with a lot of them, just to give a currently very relevant example. The spoiler effect is perhaps stronger in the US than it is in any other country, and as such, it makes for a very good case study on the matter. Looking at the polls, it might seem that the overwhelming majority of people in the US is either Democrat or Republican, with only a tiny percentage of Libertarians, Greens, and others, but this simply wouldn't be the case if Bernie Sanders supporters, just to go to the complete opposite end of the spectrum, could say they supported Sanders' socialist movement rather than describing themselves as Democrats. I think that this shows rather well that even in the US, people want political diversity to a greater extent than there currently is. Does that mean that the US, or indeed any other country currently using FPTP, should adopt proportional representation? Is it simply a better system? I don't necessarily believe so. Both FPTP and PR have advantages and disadvantages, and it's how you weigh those that ultimately decides which system you prefer. I'm personally a big advocate of proportional representation, but I can absolutely understand people who prefer first past the post as well. Please comment below with your thoughts. Until next time.